Good day, everyone, and welcome back to TMac FPV, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. Today, we're going to go over three FPV beginner tips, which you can implement before you start flying, that'll help you learn to fly FPV the right way, more quickly, and with more confidence. And if you're interested in more FPV tutorial videos, check out our Learn FPV playlist at the card up above or in the link in the video description below. Stay tuned. The first tip we'll be going over is the FPV camera angle. And actually, all three of these tips that we'll be going over today are in response to a question we recently received concerning how to learn with a slow-moving quadcopter. Actually, the question was which slow-moving quadcopter this person could get. Well, to answer this question, we took a different approach. You can actually get any quadcopter and use these three FPV beginner tips to slow it down so that you've got the opportunity to learn starting out gradually and progress at your own pace. And that's the reason we're going over these three tips. The question was, he really wants to get a slow FPV drone to try and teach his brother the basics of drones and FPV. He's flown his Maverick a few times and gets the basics of drones, but FPV is a completely different ballgame. He doesn't want anything super rapid or fast, but he still wants good quality from it. He's looked about, but it's easy to find the quick ones, the quick drones, but it's hard to find a slow-moving drone. He definitely wants something that's also mobile enough to do banking moves, but flips really don't matter at this stage. So once again, we took a different approach in answering this, and instead of picking out one particular slow-moving drone, which is what he's looking for, we're applying these three tips to slow any FPV quadcopter down so that you can learn FPV gradually, step by step, at your own pace. So, the first tip is FPV camera angle. When flying FPV, you have the same view in your goggles as the camera does on the quadcopter. In other words, both you and your camera have the same view. For the quad to fly forward and your view to be level to the ground with the horizon in the middle of your view, which is what you want when you're flying straight and level. Obviously, if you're banking, then the horizon is going to be angled one way or the other. But in order for that to happen, with the horizon in the middle of your view and level to the ground horizontally, the camera must be angled upwards. The more the camera angle, the faster forward speed you will have to maintain that altitude. So both you and your camera have the same view. In order to move forwards, you want the camera angle to be angled upwards. The greater the camera angle, the greater you're going to have to increase your throttle in order to overcome gravity and maintain your altitude, which also means by your increasing the throttle, you're going to be flying forward faster. So when you're just starting out learning to fly FPV, you want this camera angle to be somewhat small, on the order of 0 to 10 degrees. And especially if you're just starting out learning hovering, which I would recommend, you want the camera angle to be on the order of 0-ish. Or just a couple degrees, almost level to the ground, so that your quadcopter is also level to the ground. That will enable you to learn hovering. As you progress and start learning to move forwards, then you'll want to increase your camera angle to just a couple degrees, up to 5 degrees. But the point here is, when you're just starting out learning FPV, your camera angle is directly proportional to the forward speed that your quadcopter will be moving. Therefore, when you're just starting out learning FPV, you want your camera angle to be on the lower end, somewhere between 0 and 10 degrees, depending upon the maneuvers that you're trying to learn. By the way, this quadcopter flight basics is an excerpt from our foundation section in our Fast Track FPV course. And if you want more information on our Fast Track FPV course, you can obtain it through the link in the video description below. The second of our FPV beginner tips is to use Acro Trainer Mode, not Angle Mode, nor Horizon Mode. Those are two self-leveling modes which can lead to the formation of bad habits you'll need to break later on. If you use Angle or Horizon Modes, the quadcopter doesn't react to your stick movements the same way as in Acro Mode, which is ultimately the mode you want to be flying with. Acro Trainer Mode is not a self-leveling mode, and in this Acro Trainer Mode, the quadcopter does act the same as if it were in Acro Mode. However, you can limit the angle at which the quadcopter is allowed to move so it's unable to make drastic maneuvers one way or the other, potentially leading to crashes. So the best way to begin learning how to fly in Acro Mode is with this Acro Trainer mode initially. There are two aspects of setting up this Acro Trainer mode. The first is you'll need to set up the mode switch on your transmitter. This is done through two screens on your transmitter operating with OpenTX firmware. It's not difficult at all, and to save some time here, we've developed the simple one-page step-by-step checklist to accomplish this, which you can download for free at the link in the video description below. The second aspect is to enable the mode in Betaflight, and let's go ahead and take a look at how we can do that now. Now in Betaflight, there are three things that we want to do in order to enable our Acro Trainer mode appropriately. The first is go to Configuration tab and ensure that your accelerometer is turned on by toggling this switch. Save and reboot. The second is to go to your Modes tab, and note we don't have anything enabled for Angle Mode or Horizon Mode. Those are the two self-leveling modes which we do not want to use. We want to go down here to Acro Trainer Mode and add range, and in our case, both on the previous screens in this video and also in the diagrams of the checklist, which is down in the link in the video description below, we've used Channel 6, which is AUX 2, so we enable AUX 2. Then, with the switch on our transmitter, which we've set up using that checklist, we flip the switch to enable Acro Trainer mode. I've used the three-position switch, which is switch C, both in the checklist and in the previous pictures of this video. So in the middle position, I've activated Acro Trainer using my switch, and we just want to move the yellow bar over to where that little yellow blip is located. So when the switch is in the Acro Trainer position, this little yellow blip is covered by the yellow bar. If I turn the switch off, it's over here, and Acro Trainer mode is no longer active. Or it's on a three-position switch now, so if I put it in the third position, it's over here, and once again, Acro Trainer mode is not active. So since we do not have angle or horizon mode enabled, and the only mode that we do have enabled is Acro Trainer mode, which you can see after I clicked save here, it's in yellow highlighted. When I turn it off, this goes away on both sides. Therefore, whenever the little yellow blip is in this position or in this position, since we don't have horizon or angle mode enabled, that means that we'll be in Acro mode here and also here, and Acro Trainer mode here. Now, if you wanted to, you could put it on a two-position switch. I've just gone ahead and put it on a three-position switch for convenience. So that's how we enable Acro Trainer using AUX 2 or Channel 6. And you don't have to use the same channels that we did. Just use an open channel by going to the Modes tab in Betaflight. The last thing we want to do is go to our PID Tuning tab, and we actually want to set the Acro Trainer angle limit. The default is 30 degrees, and the range is from 10 to 80 degrees. Now this angle that you're setting, with the default being 30, is the maximum angle that the quadcopter will roll or pitch in the Acro Trainer mode. So you can start out with the default of 30 degrees, and as you get comfortable or more comfortable with the stick movements in this Acro Trainer mode, which is duplicating Acro mode except for this angle, you can increase this angle to, let's say, 45 degrees. And from there, as you gain more experience, keep increasing it to 60. And eventually, once you're comfortable with the stick movements in this Acro Trainer mode, duplicating Acro mode, you can eventually just turn off the Acro Trainer mode using your switch or disabling it in the Modes tab and just start flying Acro. The only difference between Acro Trainer mode and Acro mode is this angle that you're setting up here. And the advantage of using Acro Trainer over that of angle or horizon modes is that you're mimicking the stick movements of Acro mode when you're using the Acro Trainer mode. So you're forming good habits as opposed to potentially forming bad habits using those other two self-leveling modes. Go with Acro Trainer. Remember, before you exit, after setting your Acro Trainer angle limit here, you want to click save. Otherwise, it won't save the angle that you previously set up. Our third and final FPV beginner tip is to set up throttle limit. To do that, we go to PID Tuning, scroll down to this throttle limit area, hover over the question mark, and it tells us to select the type of throttle limiting, whereas off disables the feature. Scale will transform the throttle range from zero to the selected percentage using the full stick travel. That's what we want. It goes on further to say, clip will set a max throttle percentage and stick travel above that will have no additional effect. So we don't want to use clip, what we want to use is scale. Here under throttle limit percent, we set the desired throttle limit percentage. Setting it to 100 disables the feature. So what we're doing here is we're allowing our stick to travel from its lowest position on the transmitter to its highest position on the transmitter. Normally, that would go from zero throttle to 100% throttle. Here, we're going to say, you can either do this two ways, click on the arrows or just highlight it and type in 70%, say. Here, we're telling Betaflight that the maximum position of our throttle is only going to be 70% of what it normally is. So basically, you're slowing quadcopter down by setting this throttle limit percent. You can set it to a minimum of 25 and a maximum of 100. Just starting out, learning how to fly FPV, I would say set it somewhere between 60 and 70%. Let's go with 70%. And then whatever percentage you change, remember to click save. Similar to what we did with the Acro Trainer angle limit, where we're moving it from the default to 60 or 75, you can do a similar thing with the throttle limit percent. As you gain more experience and become more comfortable with the speed of the quadcopter, you can increase your throttle limit percent from 70 to say 85, which is halfway between 70 and 100. Remember to click save. And eventually, if you want to use the maximum throttle, set it to 100, because at 100, it disables the feature, or go back here and turn it off. Now I will tell you this, FPV beginners are not the only FPV pilots that use this feature. Actual professional FPV racers limit their throttle on some courses or some tracks, sometimes even all the time, and what they want to do to allow precision in their racing maneuvers is to enable better throttle resolution by limiting the throttle using throttle scaling. Because you're still using the maximum stick throw on your transmitter in order to gain a certain percentage of your throttle, which means you're able to move the stick more without the quadcopter increasing its thrust as much as it would if you were to have this set to off. In essence, what this allows you to do is help you manage your throttle better while you're racing. So don't think that just because you're an FPV beginner that this is only for FPV beginners. Many other people use this feature as well. So you're not alone when you're using this feature, and it's actually a good thing to experiment with. All right, click save. All right, those are the three FPV beginner tips that'll get you started on your journey to better FPV, fun flights, and racing stuff. If you're new or fairly new to FPV, I encourage you to check out our Fast Track FPV course description and curriculum through the link in the video description below, or simply check out this video over here. Remember to share this with your friends, because sharing is a good thing. Give it a thumbs up, smash that subscribe button. We'll see you in the next video. Clear skies, friend.